Let's start by creating a few different geometries to use as examples. First, we'll add a point, then a line, then we'll draw a rectangle, and finally, we'll use face 3/4 to make a face by setting the first 3 edges. You can see these geometries listed in the work tree to the left. Points are the simplest geometry. Lines are made of 2 vertices and an edge. Rectangles are subdivided into 4 vertices and 4 edges. Faces are comprised of 4 vertices, 4 edges, and 1 face. To model line commands, let's start by drawing a line on the work plane. Now, let's create a copy of this line and place it next to it on the work plane so that they share a point. The work tree now shows the line and its copy under the line section. To model line commands, we need to make a copy of the 2 connected lines. Using the command make wire, we'll create a polyline of the original lines. We can see in the work tree that this created 3 vertices and 2 edges. Making a compound of 2 lines will create a compound line resulting in 4 vertices and 2 edges, which will appear in the shape tree. Now, in order to model the make compound command for 2 solids, let's build a parallelepiped and a cylinder on the work tree. They do not need to be touching for the command make compound to work. After making the cylinder, select the 2 solids and then click make compound. The shape tree of the compound will appear in the work tree. The 2 solids will now function as a unit. Using the move command, we can see how they move together. Let's create some new faces to model face commands. We'll start by creating a face using face 3/4. Next, let's make a copy of this and position it so that they share an edge. Next, we'll select both faces and make copies to use as models for different commands. First, let's merge the original 2 faces. You'll have a choice of performing intersections or gluing the coinciding shapes. This creates a compound of the 2 faces. Unioning the second set will fuse the 2 faces and create 6 edges, 1 face, and 6 vertices. We'll compound the last set, which will group the 2 faces and result in 2 faces, 8 edges, and 8 vertices. The sweep command extrudes geometries along a path. We created a vertical line to act as the path for extrusion. Look what happens to various types of geometries when they are swept. The point became a line. The line became a face. The rectangle became a shell with 5 faces, and the face became a solid. Over here, we've drawn a face that we will sweep along a line with 2 segments. After clicking sweep, notice how we are selecting the first line segment and then the second segment before executing the command. A compound solid was created. The 2 solids share a face where the original line was segmented. You can see the shape of the sweep in the work tree, where it is subdivided into its subgeometries, vertices, edges, and faces.